When you think of Suzuki, of course you're going to think of these motorcycles. But we're here at Portland International Raceway with the Suzuki Kizashi sedan. This is a new bike for Suzuki called the Gladius, and this is their new sedan, the Kizashi. A new vehicle that hopes to take the Suzuki automotive brand and move it up to the same level as the Suzuki motorcycle brand. Suzuki's history in America started with the Samurai, and it was a great start. These were inexpensive, reliable SUVs that could go anywhere. They were lightweight, they were durable. However, it didn't end too well for the Samurai. It had some problems, some rollover problems, and that kind of led to the whole SUV rollover situation. I need you to erase all that, scratch all that, take all that out of your memory, and now let's look forward. In fact, the name Kizashi means something great is coming in Japanese. And it's not just coming, it's actually here. This is a mid-sized sedan, probably the biggest segment. It's over 1.7 million vehicles in America every year. We're here to tell you why this car should be on your shopping list and maybe at the top of your shopping list. Let's take you on a quick walk around this vehicle. The front fascia is very aggressive, nice big bold grille, big S, big Suzuki. I know what you're thinking. It doesn't have a lot of brand recognition, awareness in the automotive world, but you know what? You got to look past that. So a lot of mid-size sedans are not going to be as aggressive as the Kizashi. As you can see, the fenders go way out. The tires are available in 16, 17, or 18-inch. 18-inch wheels on a car this size. Very impressive. Now let's keep walking around here. As you can see, the car has relatively small proportions, but it's very roomy inside. Not quite as big as a Camry, more the size of an Acura TSX, a little bit bigger than a Mazda 3, a little smaller than a Mazda 6, just to give you an idea. Now, come around the back, as you can see, it's got a really high kind of ass. This is reminiscent of the bangle butt that was started years ago by BMW, and it just continues. Some people aren't really fond of this kind of high center, but you know what? It works for me. And the one thing that doesn't work for me are these kind of fake tailpipes over here. They're a little bit too much. It works good on the silver car, but on the darker cars like the black or the dark grays or the blues, kind of stands out a little too much. I wouldn't mind to see that being toned down a little bit, but you know what? You're not gonna look at that. That's only the person that you're passing. The basic marketing concept behind the Kizashi is premium without the premium. What they're trying to target is vehicles like the IS250, the Acura TSX, BMW 328i, and the Audi A4 2-liter Quattro. The basic design concept for the Kizashi is not to be a vanilla sleeping pill and not to be a soulless transportation appliance. When designing the Kizashi, designers looked at vehicles like the Alfa Romeo 159, the Acura TSX, and the VW Passat CC. Some of the keys to their design success were upscale design, craftsmanship, and performance. There are four basic models. Pricing starts around $20,000. The base is SE, goes to SE, GTS, and SLS. Top of line SLS is available with leather and lots of nice appointments. Again, price ranging anywhere from $20,000 up to about $28,000. Front wheel drive is standard, all wheel drive is optional, there's a 6-speed manual, and there's an automatic with CVT. That has paddle shifters, so it kind of gives you the perception that you're shifting gears even though you're not, and it's a 6-speed CVT. The only engine that's currently available is a 2.4 liter VVT inline 4. And that produces 185 horsepower for the manual, 180 for the CVT. Where you really notice the premium in the Kizashi is the interior. Everything is well integrated. The materials are tremendously upscale compared to previous Suzuki models. The Kizashi really fits nicely in the near luxury sedan segment because of all the luxury appointments. And the ride is actually very nice. It's not insulating. You still feel the road a little bit, but it's quiet enough, lots of dampening. They've really done a great job. The basic marketing message that Suzuki wants you to know is that you don't have to be over 50 to drive a luxury car. So really the way they're trying to position this car is that it's a luxury car for the masses. You think about a car that's $25,000, you probably aren't thinking Lexus or BMW. And let's face it, it's not a Lexus or a BMW, but it does offer a lot of the same kind of driving personalities that you would expect from a vehicle like that. The last thing you'd ever want to do with a vehicle like this is take it out on the track. But what did we do today? We took it out on the track, Portland International Raceway. And it was a lot of fun. We did some silly things. We did some slalom course on wet track. We did a 65 mile an hour quick maneuver, and it showed how this car outperforms the TSX and the Mazda 6. And we had this one obstacle course where we actually went through three Bozo the Clowns trying to avoid them. Of course, these exercises were designed to showcase how the Kizashi is better than the competition. All I'm saying is this car is very capable. We had it on the track by itself, and we're going 90, 100 miles an hour at Portland International Raceway. That's fun stuff. Again, nothing you're gonna do with your midsize sedan, but isn't it nice to know you can? All right, so what's the bottom line on the Kizashi? The bottom line is this. You can go buy a Camry, you could buy an Altima, you could buy an Accord just like everybody else. Or you know what? You can do something different. You can stand out from the crowd. And you know what? This car has got a 7-year, 100,000-mile transferable warranty. A 5-year, 60,000 bumper-to-bumper warranty. Again, transferable. Better check some of those other manufacturers because those warranties are not all transferable. So, would I buy this car? Yes, I would buy this car. Yes, I would put it near the top of my shopping list. It's a fun car to drive. If I had one recommendation, it's maybe a turbo, get it up to 240, 250 horsepower, but of course, that's just the enthusiast in me talking. Until then, the Kizashi, thumbs up.